Hi guys, this is page number 127. First question.
Where is the gate valve chiefly used? Answer. These valves are used chiefly where they are to be operated either wide open or closed. They are employed in steam and water pipelines of 100 to 600 mm diameter. Question. What are the advantages of these valves? Answer. The gate valve can handle all fluids. When wide open, it offers very little resistance to flow, and consequently the delta P through the valve is minimized. Question. What are the disadvantages of gate valves? Answer. Larger valves require considerable force to operate. The downstream gate is pressed very tightly against the guide by upstream pressure. 2. Very difficult to repair once the valve seats have been damaged. 3. For one-piece disc wedging between inclined seats, jamming is a problem. Also, wedging causes damage to seats and even the body. 4. Mismatch of seat and disc is another peril. Question. Why is a bypass valve fitted to a gate valve fitted to a MPHP steam header? Answer. The bypass valve is called an equalizer valve, as it equalizes the system pressure on either side of the gate valve when it is opened, and thereby relieving the downstream gate from passing tightly against the valve seat. And as consequence, it becomes easier than to open the gate valve. Note. The same philosophy applies to globe valves fitted to HP lines. Question. What is a globe valve and how does it work? Answer. It is linearly operated valve using a disc or plug-like closure member which is forced into a tapered hole called seat. The name is derived from a globular cavity around the port region. The angle used on the taper of the seat and disc varies with the valve size and kind of service to which the valve will be subjected. The valve leakage can be minimized through proper design of the disc and seat and selection of materials. The closure movement is fitted to the valve stem, which extends through the bonnet and is threaded and fitted with the hand wheel. Turning the hand wheel moves the stem in or out, thus closing or opening the valve. When opening the valve, the closure member moves perpendicularly away from the seat and orifice. To prevent leakage around the valve stem, the bonus is provided with a packing gland. Due to many possibilities of modifying the trim design for different throttling purpose, linear globe valves are traditional standard solution for control applications. Question. For what kind of service are globe valves mainly used? Answer. Globe valves are used mainly where the flow is to be throttled or modulated. Question. What are the basic advantages of a globe valve or over a gate valve? Answer. Globe valves, unlike gate valves, can readily throttle or modulate flow over a long periods without serious damage. Globe valve can act as stop check valve. Valve paths are easy to repair and replace. Question. Why are the globe valves better than gate valves in throttling service? Answer. The seats and discs on the globe valve are not cut by throttling action as readily as with gate valves. The globe valve lends itself for many design that make throttling through stages possible. For example, consider a boiler blowdown valve that releases hot dirty water from boiler drum. The valve is provided with a slagged plug that breaks down the pressure of the inlet fluid in stages, with the effect that blowdown water is released without excessive flushing, and damage due to cavitation is prevented as a sequence. Question. What are the main disadvantages of globe valve? Answer. Increased resistance to flow means higher delta P across the valve. more force is required to close the valve as the disc is acted upon by great pressure underneath. Susceptible to plugging due to ingress of foreign matter. Question: how can the globe valves act as a check valve? Answer: the valve disc is capable of sliding freely up to some distance on the stem end. Therefore, the valve can act as a check valve to prevent backflow from a common header into an ideal boiler or boiler at reduced pressure. That's how an ordinary globe valve plays a stop or check valve. Question: what is a stem guided valve? Answer: a type of globe control valves where the plug closing member is guided by a bushing facility surrounding the plug or the stem. Question: what is a control valve? Answer: it is a power actuated valve capable of throttling and modulating the flow. It is the final control element in a control loop. These valves operate automatically, receiving signals from an external controller. Rotary and globe type valves are most commonly used for this purpose. Question: what is a rotary valve? Answer: it represents a category of valves where the closure member rotates instead of moving linearly. Belonged to this family of rotary valves are ball and butterfly valves. The rotation is normally 90 degrees. Question: what is a butterfly valve? Answer: it is a rotary valve that uses a disc as the closure member. These valves are normally of water designed fitting directly between pipeline flanges. Butterfly valves can be symmetrical or eccentric, means offset, the latter referring to the disc stem bedding being displaced from the center of the disc. So these are the valves. We can see that in the diagram. Figure 4.1 is globe control valves with reversible seat rings to maximum trim life and minimize maintenance. This is the globe valves. After that, figure 4.2, null disc butterfly valves with patented seating principle consist of a double eccentric disc and a floating seat. They harness metal to metal seating for ensuring long lasting tightness in demanding control applications involving high temperatures. So we can see the butterfly valve. In 4.3, S-disc butterfly control valves are metal seated null disc butterfly valves equipped with a flow balanced trim at the valve outlet for better control performance, less noise and less cavitation. And next, figure 4.4, water sphere butterfly valves are soft seated double eccentric control valves with a single piece flexible polymeric seat that is pressure energized to ensure positive shutoff in both directions. The next question: what are S-disc valve? Answer: they are Niels Jumsbury series of butterfly control valves equipped with a flow balancing trim on the downstream side of a valve body. The trim, a perforated plate partially covering the valve outlet, reduces noise and cavitation, stabilizes the flow pattern and reduces dynamic torque on the disc. Question: what are water sphere valves? Answer: these are Niels Jumsbury series of high performance soft seated butterfly valves for control devices. The seating principle is a single piece flexible polymeric seat that is pressurized to assure positive shutoff in both directions. What is a ball valve? Answer: a rotary valve using spherical ball between two seats as the closure member. The flow opening on conventional ball valves may be full bore or reduced bore. The next question, continuation. Heavy duty metal seated ball control valves are designed for the most demanding applications. For demanding control applications, new types of ball valves have been developed with different designs of the flow opening. The R series segment control valves and Q ball valves, both the Niels Jamesbury, are the good example of advanced design using multi-stage throttling passages for low pressure recovery. What is trim? Answer: it represents the combination of flow control elements inside the valve. Included into it are the throttling member, ball, disc, plug, etc., and its stem, the seats, as well as any other parts affecting control of the flow. Thank you.
Question: what is trim? Answer: trim represents the combination of flow control elements inside a valve. Included into it are the throttling member, ball, disc, plug, etc., and its stem, the seat, as well as any other parts affecting control of the flow.
Thank you.